tengo miedo, no lo tuve defensa, sí. Fresh like it's bare meat. I been rockin' with Jesus, he part the Red Sea. I been feeling in my body, he prepared me. I'm just trying to live life so I can live again. As the world keeps spinning like a ceiling fan.
Wake up in the morning and I'm feeling fantastic. You feel me? Shout out to everybody, man. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. You feel me? We finally crossed the line, man. It's here. You know what I'm saying? All the stress. Hopefully it all simmers down from here. You know what I'm saying? Welcome back to the Only God Can Judge Me podcast. You feel me? And I want to take the time to say Merry Christmas to everybody, you know what I'm saying? Happy birthday to Jesus, you know what I mean? You know, the reason for the season, you feel me? And I also want to give a special shout out to all my new subscribers and people who share my videos, my podcast. I really, really appreciate y'all. Like, thank you from the bottom of my heart, you know what I'm saying? We rocking out, man, you know what I'm saying? We're going to keep building. It's going to keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger, you know what I'm saying? You know, and so thank you, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? And welcome back, you know what I'm saying? To another episode, we back, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, we here. So only God can judge me, you know what I'm saying? You know, first, I just wanna let everybody know, if you don't know, you know what I'm saying? The slogan comes from the late, great Tupac Shakur. You know what I'm saying? Tupac was a very, to me, he's probably one of the best rappers to ever live to do it. You know, like, his songs, his music live on for years, you know what I'm saying? You know, 20 plus years he's been gone, and some of his music is so deep, it's so spiritual almost, you feel me? That it's like, it really touches your soul, you feel me? Like, you could listen to a Tupac song and really start crying, thinking about how tough life is, you feel me? And, you know, speaking of Pac, you know, I was watching a Tupac interview that he was doing in L.A., and he was being interviewed by someone who isn't necessarily from his culture, you know. And, you know, the interview was very interesting because this person outside of his culture is, like, really curious about his life and his upbringing is so different from, you know, how Black people grow up in a lot of other ethnicities, you know what I'm saying? You know, and some of the things that he said was just so monumental and it stood out so much because it's like, you know, when he got to the party talking about how he didn't want to have kids because he didn't want to bring Black children into the world, you know? And it's so deep, you know what I'm saying? Because it's like, as a guy, you know, we always wonder what a replica of us looks like, you feel me? We always long for children in other sense, you know? And for him to be so deep in this world that's broken, that's full of hatred, racism, that's full of prejudice and stereotypes and the judgment of the world, you feel what I'm saying? You know, it's tough, you know? But so it's like, it's a little bit deeper than me because, like, I still wanted to have children and I still, you know, I have two children, you know what I'm saying? My daughter is 7 and my son is 3. And It's just like, you know, I understand though, because it's so much stuff that you have to deal with, man, on a day-to-day basis. It's like, you know, on one hand, it's like, you know, if you do have the privilege of going to a school in a nice area, which my daughter does, you have to deal with so much. Like, I get stalked by teachers. I get, you know, shunned by staff. You know, they look at me like I'm a criminal or something. And I'm like, I've been coming to this school for, like, what, 3 years now. I haven't caused no trouble. You know what I'm saying? I'm always peaceful. I'm always friendly. But somehow I still end up being looked at like a terrorist or something. You feel me? And it's just the way that the world is. You know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, you know, so at a point in time when we took my daughter out to a black school, you know, it was like, oh, heck nah. What? Like, nah. We going back to the burbs, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? Because it's just like the self-hate, you feel me? The ripple effect of, you know, snowball effect of slavery, of black people constantly being mistreated so much that we've been programmed on this mistreatment and we pour it back out on each other. You feel what I'm saying? You know, it's very unfortunate, but it's reality. You feel me? So on this podcast, you feel me, I want to make sure everybody know that, like, you know, no matter who judges you on the outside, you don't have to accept their judgment. You know what I'm saying? Because really only God is qualified enough to judge you. You know what I'm saying? And then even in that note, people think that when God's judgment, they think of, oh man, he coming, you know, for my sins, and Jesus already died for your sins. It's not a license to keep sinning. However, you know, it's already taken care of. You feel me? So, you know, God wants to reconcile with us. You feel me? He wants to come to understanding grips with that his love is far beyond your imagination. It's far beyond your understanding. It's far beyond anything that you could ever think of or imagine. You feel what I'm saying? You know, God loved me in my darkest times. You feel me? Like, man, some of the stuff that I was doing, you know, before I accepted Jesus in my heart was just, you know, it was just crazy. It was dark, man. I was working and living for the enemy. I was blind. I didn't know. You know, running with gangs and drugs and all kind of stuff. You feel me? But God, he seen me in my darkest, wickedest time. And he said, I'm going to use you. I love you. And I know one day you're going to love me back. And I don't want nothing to do with God. My mom used to be like, you don't come to church, you can, man, shoot, you're going to get a tune-up. That was the one thing that really kept a brother up in there, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to moms, you know what I'm saying? And also praying, you know what I'm saying? Having a praying mother is a powerful thing. So I just really want to encourage all the mothers out there to pray for your children, you know what I'm saying? Pray in and out of season. God hears your prayers, you know what I'm saying? You know, and I also want to, you know, start this segment off by saying, You know, it's a lot of mental health things going on in the world, man. And if we talk about it, we shed light on it, hopefully we could counteract some of these negative side effects that tend to creep up in our minds and our hearts, you know, with these mental health issues. You know what I'm saying? You know, and I want to pause right there and just, you know, have a brief moment of silence, you know what I'm saying, for somebody who passed away recently, you know what I'm saying, and somebody who was meant a lot to a lot of people. I believe his name is Stephen Boss, DJ Twitch, you know. So I'll just do a brief moment of silence. You know, this situation kind of touched my heart because, like, I woke up, you know, and doing something that we all do, some scrolling on social outlets. You know, I'm guilty, hey, I know. But I really like to keep up what's going on in society, in the world, you know what I'm saying? You know, not that I'm, like, intrigued with the world, because it's not that case, you know what I mean? But, you know, what's going on with the people in the world, you know what I'm saying? Like, so, I noticed that a lot of people from the Christian community, people that I know, was posted, rest in peace to this guy, rest in peace to this guy. And I started seeing a lot of it. I'm like, I don't even know who this guy is. I mean, do a little homework. And then it turns out that, you know, this guy was a very popular guy from DJing on a very popular talk show. But he also was a celebrity in the sense of like dancing with the stars, I believe. But to make a long story short, you know, as I unpacked this man's story and his life, it really like broke my heart because like, you know, he committed suicide, you know what I'm saying? He died by a self-inflicted gunshot wound in a motel that was down the street from his home, you know? But the thing that kind of like struck me was that like, you know, he was married, you know, he has three beautiful children. He has 2 million followers on Instagram, you know what I'm saying? You know, it seemed like every time he would go to the airport, TMZ pop out the bushes, you know what I'm saying, asking him a bunch of questions, you know, where he felt like, I don't know how he felt, but I mean, I would imagine that one would feel, you know, like, wow, this man, I never thought that my life would be like, you know, get to these heights, you know? But, you know, which kind of makes me believe that like, a lot of the things that we really long for, a lot of things that we really want, really doesn't really mean too much of anything. And the Bible says that a lot of these things are meaningless. You feel me? You know, and I'm starting to see that, man, like, you know, it's definitely true. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, it's like, you know, You can't take money, possessions, you can't take, you know what I mean, a lot of the stuff with you when you pass away, you know what I mean? And I seen interviews with him and he talked about his children and his, you know, how much is the passion for it, for him with his children, you know, really showed, you know? And, you know, for him to get to a place where it's like, you know, being tormented in the mind almost, like, it's kind of like, as men, we don't really get a lot of respect. And I'm not saying this for his situation. I'm just saying from my own personal experience and the things that I see around me, a lot of guys aren't really valued. They don't really feel valued outside of providing for financially, protecting, you know, security, stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's just, and it's not anyone's fault in particular. It's just how the world is set up. You know, Valentine's Day is for the ladies. You know, happy wife, happy life. You know how that those things going. And I feel like they're all, it's the attention and the love isn't necessarily directed to the fathers and to the men. You know what I mean? So I just want to just encourage everyone out there, like, you know, just to love on your brothers, your husbands, whoever those men could be. Because just knowing that somebody really care about your best interest, just knowing that, like, you know, people love you with a godly love, man, it could make so much difference in someone's life. You feel what I'm saying? And I just think that, you know, we have to get to a place where we realize that, you know, God is able to work with our imperfections. You feel what I'm saying? God is able to use you and to pour into you with your imperfections. You feel what I'm saying? I think that I think that religion and religious leaders and people who care more about like putting butts in the seat in the church being packed, you know, they kind of get in the way of the Spirit of God actually wanting to touch and change people because the attention is shifted. You feel what I'm saying? You know, we should have grace for the drug dealers. We should have grace for the prostitutes. We should have grace for the game bangers. We should have grace for these people who become products of their environment. You feel what I'm saying? You know, but somehow the grace is only for the saved Christian now. You feel what I'm saying? The grace is only for the people in the church. Man, miss me with all that, man. You know what I'm saying? We all need grace. We all need love. We all need God every single day. You feel me? You know? And so I just want to say rest in peace to Twitch. You know what I'm saying? DJ Twitch. You know, it's a very sad and unfortunate situation. You know, I wish that he could have been with his family on Christmas, but unfortunately, he's no longer with us. And, you know, it's a very unfortunate thing, you know. So I also want to give a shout out to Charlamagne Tha God from The Breakfast Club, because, you know, for someone who has a big voice and a big platform, he often advocates for mental health, and I think that that's very important, you know. And so, yeah, man, you know, only God can judge me, you feel me? This episode is going to be Pump Fake sponsored by Groupon. Pump Fake, yeah. Fake it till you make it, fake it till you make it, whatever you want to call it. You feel what I'm saying? But I want y'all to check out Groupon, because it's a way that you can save some dough, some money, you feel me? Like, you know, for me, if I need a smog down for a car, an oil change, I look for entertaining things to do. You know, they offer things at a discounted price. So if y'all ever, you know, want to do something special for yourself, you know, you can look up spas. They got all kind of stuff. You know what I mean? You get everything for a discounted price. So, you know, in case somebody, you ain't getting nothing for Christmas. You know what I'm saying? You know, I might not get nothing for Christmas, but I ain't tripping, because it's about Jesus anyway. You feel me? He the reason for the season. You know what I mean? And, you know, it's important for you to love yourself, because I learned about how important self-love is, because we often look for love to come from the exterior. You feel what I'm saying? From other people. But other people have broken love. They have issues that they're internal issues that they're dealing with. However, if you learn how to love yourself, you know what I mean? It is a very, very powerful thing. You know what I'm saying? And it can really, you know, you encourage yourself. You love yourself. You know, take good care of yourself. There's nothing wrong with that. You know what I mean? It could be depicted as being selfish. However, I think that that could be demonized a little bit. And I'm not trying to, you know, give a pat on the back to all the really selfish people in the world. Because I had to learn from always trying to make everybody else happy to, you know, learn how to ease up off that and learn how to make myself happy and my children happy. You know what I'm saying? You know, so, you know, shout out to everybody loving themselves. You know what I mean? But a few things that I wanted to speak about, you know what I mean, is, you know, it's how to hold on through the storm when you're going through a storm in your life, you know? For me, I'm a, you know, newly single, almost, my divorce is almost finalized, you know, and I went through a lot of dark places, a lot of depression, a lot of things that seemed overwhelming, seemed like it would never end. And somehow God has restored my joy. He took depression off of me. He's lifted me up out of my slump. You know what I'm saying? And I want people to realize how important it is to have a relationship with the Lord, because God will be in the fire with you. You know what I'm saying? It's just kind of like, just because you don't see him don't mean that he's not there, because it's like, just like I'm breathing air. I don't see the air that I'm breathing in. You know what I mean? There's a lot of things that's there that we don't see. You feel me? You know, and I just want you to realize that no matter what you're going through, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? You know, find something that makes you happy, that makes your heart, you know what I'm saying, like get filled with joy, you know? And one of the things that I really love is music, you know what I'm saying? Music makes me happy, and not just hearing it, but creating it, you know what I'm saying? And I have a lot of stuff that I'm working on, you know? And this next year is going to be a big year, man. It's going to be a big year for your boy, you know what I'm saying? You know, I'm bringing some stuff back, man, you know what I'm saying? And the music, I've been working on a lot of it. I'm going on tour next year. Yes, for the first time ever, I'm going on tour, and I'm very, very excited about it. I'm going to be documenting everything, and I'm going to be, you feel me, making sure that y'all tune in with me, man, you know what I'm saying? y'all rocking with me, so I mean, I'm gonna rock with you back. You know what I'm saying? That's just how it go. You know what I mean? That's just how it go. You know? And so I just want to thank everybody for rocking with your boy. You know what I'm saying? You know, I hope that everybody have a really, really, really wonderful Christmas. You know, I was planning on cooking the Christmas dinner, and I didn't really prepare that much. So I ain't gonna cap. You know what I'm saying? So I'm pulling up to the stores last minute. Skirt, skirt. They're like, no, we close. Oh, no, we close. We close. I'm like, oh, bruh, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Like, I got kids. I gotta feed. I gotta figure it out. You know what I'm saying? You know, the power of the brand. You know what I mean? Yeah. So, man. Everybody, Merry, Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas to your family. I love you guys. Thank you so much for rocking with me, man. The Only God Can Judge Me podcast. Christmas 2022 is almost wrapping up. So it's a good time to start doing your resolutions now. You know what I mean? Thank you guys for rocking with me. Something for a lot of the hard work and things that you do behind the scenes, there ain't gonna be no trophies for what you do. You know what I'm saying? It ain't gonna be no pats on the back for being a good parent. People may be too prideful to give you flowers, you feel me? But I want you to give your own self some flowers. Yeah, you see this? This is my trophy right here. I look at it like the thumbs up, the golden thumbs up from God. You feel me? You know, I seen this, I walked past and I was like, man, I thought about buying it, you feel me? But a lot of times I don't be buying stuff for myself, just for my kids, you know? And I was just like, I pushed my basket back in reverse, like boop, boop, boop. And I was like, you know what? Man, I'm about to buy this, you feel me? So I can encourage myself, man. And when I feel like things ain't getting the proper respect that I deserve or the proper acknowledgement for doing great, I always feel like this is gives me the self-validation that I need, you know what I'm saying? So don't forget to love yourself, man, you know what I'm saying? And remember, man, God love you, I love you, you know what I'm saying? And I wish you guys a very, 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 very Merry Christmas. Straight up.
To go gliding in the one boat.